Hello there, amazing and wonderful people of YouTube. So I made some time ago a video about Linux as a repair tool or a tool for Windows users. Well, it can also be used as a repair tool, rescue tool for Linux system. And as a repair tool, I think that's where MX Linux shines. I don't really see MX Linux as a daily driver that you install to your hard drive and all that, even though I know a lot of people do it. What I see MX Linux as, with all their tools they have in here, is a really good work tool if you have problems. A lot of people, they go in, if they have problem with their, let's just say they do an update, have a rolling release, or Ubuntu basically sets up an update, you can't boot into it, you cannot log into it or something like that. A lot of people are debating on reinstalling that system or find another distribution. Well, MX Linux actually have you covered with a really, really great tool called chroot rescue scan. What this does, it scans your computer. Let's just pretend right now I'm in a virtual box, but let's just pretend that you are on your physical hardware. You have MX Linux on a USB stick. You plop that in. It will then scan your system. So let's say you have Ubuntu installed, Debian, Manjaro, Arch, some distribution, and you install something, an update went wrong, and from one reason or another you cannot boot into your system or you cannot log into it. Well, this could potentially help you. So if you click on this one here, it will then do, it will prompt up with a code, but I already tried this tool out beforehand, so it don't ask you, but it prompt you for your root password, and root password on the live CD or live USB stick is just root. So just type that in, and here you are. It scanned my system, so it found like an Arch Linux install on device SDA1, and you can in here rescan all partition for Linux system. But let's just click this one here, and here you have it. I am in my quote unquote physical hardware, or in this case my virtual machine. So I am actually using Arch Linux now. So if I go in here and do a Pac-Man, oh, I have to remember that we are on US keyboards. Wait, I cannot remember the update. There you go. I can now update Arch Linux. I couldn't for the life of me remember it. So right now I'm actually controlling my physical Arch install, or in this case my hard disk on a virtual machine that have Arch installed. Like I said, this could be Debian or something like that. I don't want to update this one because this is my test virtual machine. So just click no. But let's just say you had like a boot problem. So you could do like, I think it's crop update. I still need to remember that I'm on a command log for. Anyway, I can't remember that command right now. I should have. It's because I spelled it wrong. Is that why we do it? No, I can't remember the command, but there's command to update crop. I will put the command on the screen so you guys can see it. There's a command to update crop. There are commands for doing all kinds of things to help you rescue your system. Again, you can also use Pac-Man. Again, I don't know why my brain is so foggy today. Again, I'm on a US keyboard. Again, I cannot. Why can't I? I cannot use a computer today. I might as well just sit and watch anime all day. So we have Pac-Man here. Pac-Man can actually help you reverse what you have done. I will do that maybe if you guys want it. I can show you guys how to reverse to another state or downgrade or something like that to before an update with Pac-Man, just like you can with Debian and stuff like that, without you have to go in and redo your system. You get what I'm saying here? Let's say we have so we can go into etc, like you see here I'm in etc right now. So you can go in and you can edit config files, you can go in and see if you, let's say you have like a program that's can run, I don't know, some sort of, you have like a backup system in here that runs from the command line, so you can just do run backup tool dash one. So this is just a fictional command that I just made up in my mind. So that, let's just say, okay, this is backup tool that then will be, take you back from the first backup. And then if you have, like, let's say five backups, you could do like one is the oldest, two is the second oldest, three is the youngest. Let's just pretend that. So let's say, oh, yeah, just did an update and it bounced up. So let's say you roll back to like your backup, you have your system that's this the middle child or the second oldest. You can do like this, you know, all these kind of things you can do in here via the CH terminal or CH command. I should have said this in the beginning, forgive me for that, but basically what CH root means is that it's changed root directory. Basically, you are, think of it as remote viewing, remote desktop and stuff like that. This is just in the command line. You're just remote controlling a PC. In this case, we're just doing it from a USB stick or a CD or however you are doing it. Again, I'm so sorry for my brain being all over the place today. I don't know. I think I need to drink some more water. I think I'm being dehydrated, to be honest. But you can basically do almost anything that you will be able to do if you could boot into like a terminal state in your PC. So you don't have to go and reinstall everything. Let's just say you decide to reinstall everything anyway. So you could go into home, and in this case, test is my home directory, and then you can just back all this off. So like, let's say a USB stick, or if you have like some documents or something in here that you really, 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 really need. Save, let's say you have like your config file, you can back that up. You want to have backed up some of your documents before you reinstall it. In case it goes up, you could basically copy them here and then copy them over to this USB stick and save it here, or to another USB stick and save them, or you can print them out from this environment here if it's documents. Or let's say you have a server, you that the backup happened yet, or you forgot to back it up, you can then now go in here, and then if you just have a Samba server, you could basically just log into your Samba server via the file manager here, and then, you know, oh well, you cannot do that in here, sorry, my mistake. But you can log in to your server via the terminal and then copy over your files to the server, or copy the files over to the MX Linux, and then from MX Linux to your server via the terminal, or not via the terminal, but via the file manager here. If we are not talking about 10 gigabytes of space and stuff like that, if it's just document, you know, they should be small enough for you to do that, because there are limits on how much space you have on your hard drive. You see, you have free space, 3 gigabytes. So you cannot, like, let's say, save 10 gigabytes in the, let's call it the buffer on the USB stick, or the virtual hard drive on the USB stick. You are limited to this. I think they have tools so you can expand this so it gets bigger. So the onboard hard disk on MX gets bigger, but again, video for another day. But I hope this kind of gives you an idea of that some of the tools that they have here that actually makes it really, really good as a rescue machine. But you get the idea here. I am controlling my hard drive on my quote-unquote physical system that are basically ruined with an update, or Ubuntu ruined with an update, or whatever distribution you use, you can use chroot. You don't need MX Linux for it, but MX Linux just make it easy, if you know what I'm saying here. You can take, I think, chroot, you can use that from an Ubuntu Live CD. Don't hold me up on it, but I think you can do that. And then go into it. But like I said, MX Linux just have this smart tool down here called chroot rescue scan. I don't know if this is their own tool or if it's something you can download from the repositories. Let's see here. It's called chroot rescue scan. So it could just be a generic tool, I'm not sure. But they have it pre-installed in here. And that's what makes MX Linux great as a tool, like a rescue tool, or just like a, if you want to run Linux without taking space on other people's hard drives. Let's say you're at your friend's house and you just want to log into a Linux machine because you want to go on the internet for some reason. you can use MX Linux or any other live CD for that matter. But it just gives you an idea of the power of live CDs and the power that you have with Linux and the power you have with Linux machine talking to Linux machines. You could not see Hroot into a Windows machine, sadly, but I think there is other tools where you can do kind of the same thing. But at least in here, right now, if you had like a, if this was a Linux machine, there are ways to go into the hard drive via gparted or stuff like that to find, you know, your hard drive in other ways. But sadly, I don't have any virtual machines with Windows on it because I have a Windows partition, so I don't need it. But maybe I should set up a virtual machine with Windows on and we could try that out and see how easy or how hard it is to recover data from a bricked, or not bricked, but from a ruined Linux, not Linux, Windows install. That could be maybe the next video or something like that. But I hope this gave you an idea how important it can be to just have a USB stick with MX Linux on it or any other distribution with some tools on it in case something goes wrong. I have not personally used this before because when things go wrong with my Linux partition, I just install another Linux distribution. But I can see it like if you're one of those people that don't want to try new distributions, you just want, let's say, have Arch or Debian testing or any other, or Tumbleweed, OpenSUSE Tumbleweed or Ubuntu. You just want Ubuntu installed and you just use the updater from the distribution updater from version to version. And then, oh, login screen is out of order. You try to go into like a TTT terminal and that's kind of a little bit iffy. Well, you can go in here basically from a fresh system, then log into your broken system and then try to see if you can figure out what's wrong. Maybe change out a config file and stuff like that. And the great thing about this compared to going into a TTT terminal, like if I do like this, you could do this on your system. Let's see if I can remember what... where they keep the UI. It's 7 here. What's great about this here is that you still have the ability to go into the internet if you have a problem, you need to research it. You cannot do that if you're using a TTY terminal, you know, like this on your physical hardware. You could download terminal, what you call it, web browsers, but let's just be real, say it's only for nerdy people that get a hard-on by that use those. Us real people that live in the real world, we use stuff like this. And then you can go in here and like, okay, how to update crop on Arch. Let's just do that because I could not use the remember that command. And I installed it wrong, just like I did in the command. And I think it was because I was calling crop with a P instead of with a B. Let's see if I was right. And you guys have been yelling at me. No, I did set a B. But let's just say it here, it's update crop. I just totally messed those commands around. So as you guys saw here, I just did an update. I just highlighted it. Oh, that's for Ubuntu. Here you go. Here it is. I was thinking about Ubuntu. That's right. You need this one here. Let's see if this works. So I just highlighted, copy it. Click on the terminal. Go down to here. I should be able to just middle click, click enter, and now it's updating crop. Let's just say your crop was botched up or it was missing something, and then you went in and edit the crop file yourself, and then you can update crop now. And now you can basically, let's say you edit something in crop file, it went wrong, you cannot use crop anymore, you cannot boot into your system. You see Hroot with this tool into your system, go into crop, reverse the thing you did in the crop file, and now you run a crop update or crop make config, and now you can boot into your Arch system without you having to reinstall everything or have off your phone, right, you know, having, you know, your phone up as a browser and read commands and all that because you're using a TTY terminal. You can basically just use MX Linux or any other Linux distribution to have these capabilities to do this in a more convenient fashion, in a workflow that makes it kind of like if you're using a, like I said, you're using a PC with a desktop and all these fancy things we can do. And it's really, really amazing. And I just talked myself into actually buy a separate USB stick that's 3 gigabytes, or I was maybe buy 10 or 16. And then have that laying around with MX Linux on it. And then just update it every time MX Linux gets updated, because they have a lot of great tools. Like I said, this is where MX Linux in my case shines. It's an amazing tool for people that do these kind of things. I know a lot of people use it as their data driver, all power to them for that. I just think this is where it shines. This is MX Linux array, if you can say it like this. And like I said, we are in Arch down here. I could update it if I want, as you guys saw up here. This is the update. And it says here Arch Linux. I'm in Arch Linux. So I hope this was a little bit interesting and piqued your interest. Just imagine what you can do on a broken Windows system. Like I said, maybe we should investigate that at some point in the video. Like I said, Linux, talking with Linux is the best scenario, you know, because Linux tool works with Linux tools for the best, you know. That's just how the world is. So yeah, let me hear what you guys think about this. Have you ever considered having a old USB stick with a Linux distribution on it in case your installation goes tits up? Or are you one of those people that just like, you know what, fuck it, I just reinstalled or I installed another distribution? I know I was. I used to, because I was not that married or that invested into my Linux that I had installed on my physical hardware. Mostly because I like to tinker around with different distributions. I'm out of here, see y'all later, bye bye.